My warm greetings to everyone, and welcome to my lecture presentation about science, technology, and sustainable development. My name is Michael Victor Gonzalez from West Visayas State University, College of Agriculture and Forestry. So let's start. So the science and technology, it plays a crucial role in advancing our sustainable development goals by providing the tools, innovations, and knowledge needed to address global challenges such as poverty, climate change, food security, and environmental degradation. So, while our technological advancement have brought a substantial benefits, they also have a significant environmental impact which need to be managed carefully. So, this lecture will explore the role of science and technology in achieving the sustainable development goals with examples from ASEAN regions and the global context, and discuss the environmental implications of technological advancements. The role of science and technology in sustainable development goals. So the Sustainable Development Goals are 17 global goals established by the United Nations in 2015, aimed at ending poverty, protecting the planet, and ensuring the prosperity for all by 2030. The science and technology are pivotal in achieving these goals by providing innovative solutions and a driving progress across various sectors. So let's take a look about the key sustainable development goals supported by the science and technology. Number one, the sustainable development goal one, no poverty. The science and technology can contribute to reducing the poverty by increasing our agricultural productivity, creating job opportunities through innovation, and improving access to essential services. So, example, in our country, the Philippines, the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund, supported by the scientific research and agricultural technology, has helped smallholder farmers increase their rice yields and improve their livelihood. Next is the SDG 2, Zero Hunger. Technological innovations such as precision farming, genetically modified crops, mobile applications for farmers that can help increase food production and reducing our problem in hunger. In ASEAN example, in Vietnam, the adoption of precision agriculture through GPS and data analytics has helped farmers optimize resource use and they increase their yields and improve food security. So in a global example, the use of drought-resistant corn varieties in Africa, developed through biotechnology, has improved food security in regions that are prone to drought. So sustainable development goal number six is clean water and sanitation. Science and technology enable the innovations in water purification, desalination, and waste water treatment, essential for providing access to clean water and sanitation. In a global example in India, the Aqua mobile app used technology to monitor the water quality in some of the rural areas in India, and they ensure safe and clean drinking water to their communities. So the sustainable development goal number seven is the affordable and clean energy. Renewable energy technologies such as solar, wind, and hydropower are essential for reducing the reliance on fossil fuel and ensuring the access to clean and affordable energy. We all know that the combustion out of the fossil fuel causes an emission that is harmful to our atmosphere. So that's why the science and technology are innovating for other means and other source of energy that is environmentally friendly, like our solar and our wind energy. So for example, in Thailand, investment in solar energy have enabled the country to increase its renewable energy and contributing to its goal of generating 30% of electricity from renewable source by 2036. So in the global example, the growth of the solar energy sector in Germany has helped reduce carbon emissions and provided a model for other countries that are seeking to transition to clean energy. And also our sustainable development goal number 9 is the industry, innovation, and infrastructure. The science and technology are driving innovations in our infrastructure, transportation, and industry, enabling more efficient and sustainable production processes. So in Singapore, they have a smart nation initiatives, leverage technology to improve their urban infrastructure, transportation, as well as their services that contributing to more sustainable and resilient urban development. And the use of 3D printing technology in construction has reduced material waste and energy consumption in building industry. So nowadays, we can only see this technology way back a few years ago in only, it's like a sci-fi. But nowadays, the 3D printing technology is now available in the industry. Next is the Sustainable Development Goal 13, the Climate Action. Technologies such as carbon capture and storage, renewable energy, and climate resilient agriculture are essential for mitigating the impacts of climate change. So in Indonesia's use of satellite technology to monitor the deforestation and forest fires has helped the country take action against illegal logging and reduce carbon emissions. So in our global example, the development of electric vehicles and improvements in battery technology have contributed to reducing the greenhouse gas emission in the transportation sector globally. So what are the challenges and opportunities? So while the science and technology are vital for achieving the sustainable development goal, they also present challenges, including accessibility, ensuring that the technological innovations will reach the poorest and most vulnerable population. That is one of the challenge on how to distribute this technology to a wide beneficiary. And also ethical consideration. The development and the use of technologies most consider social, ethical, and environmental implication. So we should always understand the impact of the technologies that are available. And if we can be able to have a better understanding and can be able to mitigate its negative impact, we can manage and can be able to make it even more better. Then another challenge is the capacity building. Developing countries often lack the infrastructure to support this advanced innovation, and also lack of manpower to have in terms of expertise to fully benefit from the advanced technologies. So let's proceed to environmental impacts of technological advancements. So technological advancements have a significantly improved our well-being, but they have also led to environmental degradation in a larger scale of these operations. And this resource depletion because of the volume that is being required to produce because of the number of populations that are in need of that product. So the resource depletion are occurring. And biodiversity loss, expansion of the plantations or infrastructure, our biodiversity are in great challenge. So the sustainable development requires balancing this technological progress with environmental protection. So this both should go hand in hand. We cannot just make a massive growth and progress in our technological and societal well-being that we will neglect our responsibility in environmental protection, because later on it will catch up to the society by means of calamity, natural calamities that we don't want to happen, and our future generations are actually at the risk of facing these consequences if we will not be able to solve it as earlier, as soon as. So here we do have a positive environmental impacts of technology. And as we discussed in the prior slides, the renewable energy. So these technologies may develop like solar, wind, and hydropower that are considered sustainable. So these technologies reduce the reliance on fossil fuels and help combat the climate change. And in ASEAN example, in Sarawak Corridor of Renewable Energy in Malaysia has promoted the use of hydropower, reducing the carbon emissions and supporting sustainable energy development. So in Denmark, focused on wind energy has made it a global leader in renewable energy, with wind power accounting for over 40% of its electricity production. So another one is the precision agriculture. The precision farming technologies help reduce use of water and fertilizers and pesticides, minimizing the environmental impacts while maximizing the productivity. So in ASEAN example in the Philippines, the use of the drip irrigation and remote sensing technologies in agriculture has improved water use efficiency, contributing to sustainable water management. So in global example in Australia, their drones and also their satellites have the ability to capture an image that are used to monitor crops, health, and optimize the resource use that reduced the environmental impact of farming. So another, let's take a look at the negative environmental impacts of technology. So the number one is the industrial pollution. So the technological advancements in manufacturing and industrial processes have led to increased pollution and waste, contributing to air and also water and greenhouse gas emission. So this pollution is very harmful to humans, to our environment, that leads to our environmental degradation. So for example, the rapid industrialization in Indonesia has contributed to severe air pollution in urban areas, partly due to the reliance on coal-fired power plants. So for the global example, the Great Smog of London in 1952 was a direct result of industrial pollution, leading to thousands of deaths and prompting a reforms in air quality management. Another one is the e-waste as part of the negative environmental impact. So there are plenty of environmental, or what we call this, e-waste. So the rapid advancement of information and communication technology, where our smartphones have a new model every succeeding months, and the consumer will buy again another new model to satisfy their wants of the certain features of the technology. So this lead to a significant increase in electronic waste, which possess a serious environmental threats, because this technology cannot just be thrown in our landfill, because it contains some harmful and poisonous materials that it requires a thorough or a further waste management. So for example, in Malaysia, the growth of the electronics industry has resulted in increasing amounts of e-waste, much of which is improperly disposed and leading to environmental contamination. And that is very harmful to our environment, especially for our water resource that can lead to a contamination that will make a significant consequences to humans and to the environment. So in the global perspective, an estimated 50 million tons of e-waste is generated each year, with only 20% is being recycled properly. So what will happen to the 80% of that 50 tons? So they will just be left in our landfill that is not properly disposed. So that's part of the major negative impact of technology. Then our resource depletion. As our technology advance, and as the humans in our society are demanding for a more output, more resources, our resources are depleting. The extraction and use of our natural resources for technological advancements, such as mining for metals that are used in electronics, has led to deforestation. And this will result to a loss of biodiversity and ecosystem degradation. So for our global example, the mining of the rare earth metal that used in smartphones and electronic vehicles has caused a significant environmental damage. So in countries like China, where unregulated mining has polluted water source and destroyed the ecosystem. Okay, so for our mitigating environmental impacts of technology, so to ensure that technological advancements will contribute to sustainable development, so it is essential to mitigate their environmental impacts. So some strategies include the circular economy, promoting a circular economy approach where products are designed to be reused, repaired, and recycled, this minimizing waste. Another one is green technologies. So if we can be able to invest in green technologies, such as renewable energy, like our solar panel, our wind turbine, and also even our hydro power can be also utilized. So we can be able to create a better source of energy that are more environmental friendly, and also the eco-friendly materials that are degradable or biodegradable that will not cause a contamination in our land and water resources, and also the energy efficient processes. So this can contribute to the mitigating the environmental impact of this technology. And also, if we can be able to, if our policymakers can be able to implement the environmental regulations that will strengthen our environmental policies and regulations to really control the industrial pollution, to manage e-waste, and also the natural resources. So with this, actually, we can see the progress in our policies. We can see in our barangays that they are trying to implement the MRF, the Material Recovery Facility. So that is already a good start to create an awareness in every community of our role in making our environment into a more sustainable and adapt in a mindset of preserving our environment. And we have a major responsibility, we the society, has a great responsibility to make our environment not to be contaminated by so much product of the technology that we are using. So for our conclusion, science and technology are indispensable for achieving the sustainable development goals. So since that is our main topic where we want to attain development, but we should also balance it with sustainability. But they must be applied through thoughtfully to ensure that they do not exacerbate environmental and social issues. So the technology should not create a harmful effect. So by promoting a sustainable technological practices, investing in green innovations, and addressing the ethical and environmental challenges associated with technological progress, the ASEAN region and the world can move closer to achieving a sustainable development. It is essential to balance the benefits of technological advancements with their potential environmental impact to secure a prosperous future for all. So for our references for this discussion, so you may access this link and also these references to give you more insights. So thank you very much for being part of this lecture presentation. And I really hope that you gained a substantial information about sustainable development goal, and it can be able to frame your perspective and have a glance of sustainability in looking for our development, especially for using technologies in our modern times. So thank you very much, and I will look forward for another lessons. So thank you very much, and I'll see you again on our next topic.